There are so many AI app building tools right now that it can be overwhelming to know which one to choose. In this video, I'm going to go over my favorite 6 AI app builders right now, including one that I don't think you've heard of before. I don't want to waste any time, so let's jump right in with Base 44. Base 44 just sold for $80 million to Wix, and it is definitely one to check out. Now, I'm going to go over the high-level reasons of why you should check out Base 44, along with the other tools coming up later in the video. Base 44, one of the really great things about it is everything is integrated all-in-one, meaning the backend database, so where the data is stored for your app, is integrated directly into the platform. So you don't have to sign up for a separate service such as Supabase or Neon for a separate database. It's all going to be integrated. And that also goes for authentication, meaning people can log in to your app. So these things are all integrated. Now there are pros and cons to this. The pro is that it's easier to get started with. It's one of my favorite app builders right now just to get started with if you are brand new, but you don't have as much flexibility with the database and because it's all integrated into Base 44. So if you want complete control over your database, then this tool wouldn't be for you. But if you want an easy tool to get started with, Base 44 is great. The next one I recommend is Bolt. That's bolt.new. What I really like about Bolt is its integrations. Just as an example, down here, you can integrate with Figma to pull in your Figma file and start from that. You can also import from GitHub, which is really nice. And one of the things I want to point out about Bolt is the pricing. So they charge you by tokens, meaning they're going to charge you by how basically in-depth and complex the tasks you give the AI are. This is just something to keep in mind in terms of pricing. That makes it a little different from other tools like Base 44, which charge you for each message. Here with Bolt, you're going to be charged by tokens. In terms of whether the output of Bolt versus Base 44 is better right now, for that kind of thing, I definitely recommend checking it out and using it yourself. They all have free plans to actually try it out and see how it does. But Bolt, I've had a really good experiences with. It does have that external database you connect to something like Supabase. But overall, I do really like Bolt, and I think it's a really high quality tool and definitely worth checking out. So Lovable. Lovable is one of the most popular ones along with Bolt that you may have heard of before. I also recommend checking it out. Similarly to Bolt, it has a separate Supabase database that you would need to connect to. It's not integrated like Base 44. They also are just changing their pricing model right now. So before, their pricing model was by message. They're just introducing a new AI agent mode that basically is going to decide how much to charge you based on the complexity of the task. So that's just something to keep in mind. But otherwise, the features of Lovable are going to be pretty similar to Bolt. So I definitely recommend checking out both and just seeing which one you vibe with more. These are vibe coding tools. You want to see which one you vibe with the most. So Lovable is definitely one that you want to check out. Now, the next one I'm going to show you, I think that you may not have heard of it before. That tool is Memex. Memex is different from the other tools in a couple ways. First, it is pretty agnostic in terms of the coding language that you're going to use. For Lovable, for example, it is going to typically use React and Vite, which I'm not going to get into all the details of the pros and cons of that, but just know that if you want to build a Python app, Lovable isn't going to be best for that. And I don't think Bolt or Base 44 is going to be best for that either. Memex allows you to do Python. It allows you to really do any type of coding language that you want. It also is an app that you download onto your computer. So all the code is going to be stored locally, although you can sync it to GitHub if you want. And I also find it to be a little bit, it's a middle ground between using something like Bolt and Lovable, which are, or Base 44 even, which is really for beginners, and then Cursor, which is going to be for people who are a little bit more advanced. This is a little bit in the middle with some of the more powerful features and basically ability to have more control over what you're doing with Cursor, but then also it's very easy to get started with, and the agent really takes care of a lot on its own. It does a lot of debugging. So this is definitely one to check out. I think it's definitely worth checking out, especially if you want a tool that's a little bit more powerful and has a little bit more flexibility than something like Bolt and Lovable. The next one I want to recommend is Emergent. That is emergent.sh. The reason I like Emergent is I find it to be a very agentic tool. Agentic meaning that you give it one prompt and it is just going to go through and use multiple agents to build out your idea, do debugging. It does a lot of it on its own. And that's what I really like about Emergent. We can click into something I've built before and you can see, really, it's just like this was like all in one prompt, essentially, that it did all of these things. Again, a lot of these tools promise similar things, meaning you enter in text, you get an app as a result. So I recommend, these are all tools that I would recommend using and trying and seeing which one you like the best after using it. And finally, there is Replit. This is also another very popular one that you may have heard of before. Something that's nice about Replit is it also has that integrated database. So you don't have to use an external database. It's all going to be integrated into one tool. I personally haven't had as much luck building in Replit as some of the other tools. I've just seemed to have gotten stuck a little bit more. However, these tools are improving a lot every day, so it's very possible that by now it's going to be working just as good, if not better, than the other tools. But this is one of the most popular tools. They have a really great team, and it's definitely worth checking out Replit as well. As a bonus, I have to mention Cursor. Cursor is going to be for people who are a little bit more technical or a little bit more comfortable with coding or how apps work. It has actually a very similar type of feature to Bolts and Lovable and all of the other tools I mentioned, where you can just chat on the right side and it's going to write the code. My suggestion, if you want to use Cursor, but you are a little unfamiliar with using tools that are like coding environments like this, is anytime you're getting stuck, you're not sure what to do, just ask the agent in Cursor what to do, and it will help you tell you what to do, what commands to give in Terminal, things like that. But Cursor is a bonus. I think it's a really great tool to understand, especially because you might want to start with one of the first six tools that I talked about, then connect your code to GitHub and then import it into Cursor and then start building in Cursor, because it is going to be less expensive in Cursor typically than some of these other tools. And you're also going to have a little bit more control. You may want to graduate into Cursor potentially, or Windsurf is another very similar tool to Cursor. Let me know what you think in the comments. Have you used any of these tools? Let me know which ones you think. Which ones did I miss that I should cover in the next video? Subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more free content like this, and we'll see you in the next video.